Good morning, students. We have started cash flow statement. Today, in cash flow statement, we will learn how to prepare fixed asset account, investment account, proposed dividend account. Because sometimes they will not give inflow outflow of cash directly, right? You know that we have to find out cash flow from operating activity, cash flow from financing activity, cash flow from investing activity separately. So for that we need inflow and outflow of respective activities. Say for example, if I have to calculate cash flow from investing activity, so I need purchase of asset, sale of asset, purchase of investment, sale of investment. So that particular information may not be given directly. So in that case, we shall have to prepare fixed asset account and investment account. Similarly, when we calculate cash flow from financing activity, in that case we have to prepare equity share capital, preference share capital, debentures, long term borrowing, proposed dividend, right? So today this class solely will be regarding how to prepare various accounts so that I can get inflow outflow for respective activity, right? So give the heading. How to prepare various accounts. So first of all, we will learn how to prepare fixed asset account. Now, you have done depreciation accounting, and in that depreciation accounting, you know that there are two methods of charging depreciation. One is charge depreciation directly to fixed asset account, right? With the amount of depreciation, the value of fixed asset decreases. Second method, charge depreciation to accumulated depreciation account. In that case, depreciation is not charged directly to fixed asset account. It is being accumulated, right? So we have two methods by which we can prepare fixed asset account. Number one is gross method, and number two is net method. Under gross method, we prepare fixed asset account, we prepare accumulated depreciation account, we prepare asset disposal account. This particular account is maintained at original cost. This account, accumulated depreciation, we show depreciation charged, and this account is prepared with respect to assets sold. Is that fine? So from fixed asset account, I will get information relating to purchase. From accumulated depreciation, I will get information with respect to depreciation. And asset disposal, I get information with respect to sale. While on the other hand, if I prepare asset account under net method, so in that case, I will prepare a single account, that is fixed asset account. And you know that this is the debit side, which is inflow. This is the credit side, which is outflow. So all information with respect to fixed asset, I will get from this particular account only. Such as, if I have to get purchase of asset, I will get from this account. If I have to get depreciation charge during the year, I will get from this account. If I have to find out sale of fixed asset, I will get from this account. It means all information I will get from this particular account only. Here, purchase, okay, I want to find purchase, I will prepare fixed asset account. Okay, I want to find depreciation, I will prepare accumulated depreciation. I need to get sale related information, so I will prepare asset disposal account. So today I am going to give you a lot of examples. With the help of that, you are going to understand how to calculate cash flow from financing activity with respect to fixed asset. Because for calculating cash flow from financing activity, we need purchase and sale of asset. And if information is not directly provided, how much is inflow of asset, how much is inflow of cash when I sell the asset, how much is outflow of outflow of cash when I purchase the asset. If that inflow outflow of cash is not given directly, in that case I will prepare fixed asset account. So it depends upon the type of information provided to us in the problem. Right? Now students will ask, sir, which method to follow? So I will tell you, note. Whenever opening and closing balance of depreciation is provided, we shall prepare fixed asset account under gross method. Is that fine? So you have to look for opening and closing balance of accumulated depreciation. If opening and closing balance of accumulated depreciation is provided, in that case we shall prepare fixed asset account under gross method. Right? So without wasting any time, let us start example number one. Right? This is the opening date, this is the closing date, right? Fixed asset 2 lakh, 3 lakh 50. Accumulated depreciation, this is fixed asset at cost, right? Accumulated depreciation 50,000, 80,000. Additional information, 1 asset costing rupees 50,000 WDV rupees 30,000 has been sold for rupees 18,000. Another asset costing rupees 20,000, accumulated depreciation rupees 15,000 has been discarded. Prepare cash flow from investing activity. So this is the problem which they have given us. That's very simple. So you can see that accumulated depreciation opening and closing balance is provided. So in that case we shall prepare fixed asset account under gross method, isn't it? Right? Since opening and closing balance of accumulated depreciation is provided, then in that case I will go for gross method. So in that case I have to prepare 3 accounts, that is fixed asset account, accumulated depreciation and asset disposal. So let us start. If anyone has not yet copied, right, kindly pause the video and just copy it fast. It will save our time. Let's move. Okay. Solution. This is very easy. You have done at the elementary level of accounting. First of all, I will prepare fixed asset account. Then I will prepare accumulated depreciation account. Right? So now, whenever you have to prepare asset under gross method, with respect to each item, you have to prepare three accounts. Now, fixed asset, debit balance 2 lakh and 3 lakh 50. Right? Now, accumulated depreciation, it's a credit balance. It's a provision for depreciation. Right? You are getting, you are accumulating the funds. The fund is, will have a credit balance. So, opening balance is 50. Closing balance is 80. Is that fine? So, I have put up the balances. Fixed asset debit balance, right? This is debit balance and these are credit balance. I guess this is absolutely fine. Okay. Now they have given us two additional information with respect to fixed asset. One asset costing rupees 50,000, WDV 30. Now tell me one thing. Costing 50, WDV 30, what does it mean that? Accumulated depreciation is rupees 20,000. Yes or no? It clearly means that accumulated depreciation is 20,000. That 50,000 I purchased few years back. Till now I have provided 20,000 as depreciation. So WDV is 30,000. Is that fine? Yes or no? So whenever an asset is sold, you have to keep one thing in mind that you have to remove that asset from fixed asset. And asset sold, depreciation of asset sold, you have to remove from accumulated depreciation. This asset account is a group of all assets and this accumulated depreciation is the depreciation total of all assets. So when any particular asset is sold, its cost will be removed from fixed asset. Its accumulated depreciation will be removed from accumulated depreciation account. Is that fine? So, buy asset disposal. I will remove 50,000 from here and transfer it to asset disposal. Right? Similarly, we have to remove accumulated depreciation of assets sold from accumulated depreciation account. So it's a credit balance. In order to remove, I have to debit. So to asset disposal, 20,000. So here I will write by accumulated depreciation, 20,000. Now in asset disposal, we have WDV 30,000. Is that fine? So whenever an asset is sold, its original cost and its accumulated depreciation will be removed from fixed asset and accumulated depreciation account respectively. So you can write here, note, whenever any asset is sold / discarded, then its cost and accumulated depreciation will be removed from fixed asset and accumulated depreciation account respectively. Is that fine? So asset is sold, its cost has been removed, its accumulated depreciation has been removed. WDV has no relevance. So if they give you WDV, you calculate accumulated asset sold, accumulated depreciation. So cost has been removed from fixed asset and accumulated depreciation has been removed from accumulated depreciation. Now in asset disposal, we have WDV. So now I'll write by bank. It has been sold for 18,000, if you remember, right? So automatically by PL, we have a loss 12,000. So one asset, it's over. Another asset costing 20,000 and accumulated depreciation is directly given. So no need to calculate. So again, its cost will be removed from asset disposal, accumulated depreciation will be removed from accumulated depreciation account. So here I will write two fixed asset, cost comes in, and by accumulated depreciation, the accumulated depreciation till date comes in. So now it has been discarded, means there is no sale proceeds. So automatically by PL, loss 12,000. Discarded means thrown away, scrap is zero. Right? Is that fine? Now, I have already told you that there is no other information. From fixed asset we get to bank account. Purchase balancing figure, and from accumulated depreciation I will get depreciation charge during the year, is that clear everyone? Now we have got so many informations, but I need only inflow outflow of cash to calculate cash flow from financing activity. There are so many information. There is purchase, there is depreciation during the year, there is loss on sale, there is sale proceeds, right? So many informations. So which information is relevant for me? This purchase is relevant for me. and this sale is relevant for me. That's it. Is that fine? So now I'll prepare. Sorry. Cash flow from investing activity. Is that fine, everyone? Right, let us move to example number 2. These balances are extracted from fixed asset account. Right. Now in the given problem, you can see that from the balance sheet, there is only one figure of fixed asset. And in the additional information, they have given accumulated depreciation, opening and closing balance. So from the given information, it is quite evident that this fixed asset balance is net. So in the balance sheet, they have given us net value of fixed asset. So now you tell me that I am going to prepare fixed asset under gross method or fixed asset under net method. See, I have already told you that whenever you get any information related to accumulated depreciation, opening and closing balance, then you are going to prepare under gross method. But here they have given us net method. Now tell me one thing. In case of first example, can you tell me what is being added to the balance sheet total? It is 1,50,000, 2,70,000. Yes. It is the net figure which forms part of balance sheet total. So if they have given us net figure, that does not mean that we will follow gross net method. See whether information of accumulated depreciation is given or not. Yes, it has been given. So I can easily get the gross value of fixed asset. In the first example also, when we prepare balance sheet, the net figure will form part of balance sheet total. The net figure. Right? So whether you follow gross method, whether you follow net method, in the balance sheet total, net is forming part. That is clear. Now the question is whether to prepare asset under gross method or net method. That purely depends upon this factor. Have they given us opening and closing balance of accumulated? Yes, they have given us in example 2. Yes, they have given us. So can I not calculate the, will I be able to calculate the gross value of fixed asset? Yes, sir, you will be able to calculate. So therefore, we will prepare asset under gross method only. Is that fine? So let us do the solution. Right? So in the given problem, you can see that when I write the opening balance, 4 lakh is net. I will add up the opening balance of accumulated depreciation, so I will get the gross value. That is original cost. Six lakh, I'll add 1,80,000. Is that fine? So if they have given us net, check whether accumulated depreciation opening closing available. Okay, I can get the gross figure. No issue. Now they have given us only one information, that asset costing 50,000 and its accumulated depreciation is 25. So whenever asset costing 50,000 accumulated depreciation this much is sold, we will remove the original cost from fixed asset and its accumulated depreciation from accumulated depreciation account. So I'll write by asset disposal 50,000 एंड टू एसेट डिस्पोजल 25,000। Right, its original cost and accumulated depreciation has been removed. Sale proceeds is being credited to asset disposal because all information of assets sold is there in asset disposal account. So 2PL, I'll get the profit part. Is that fine? So this was the main point which we need to crack, that if they have given net balance in balance sheet, that does not mean that asset will be prepared under net method. This is main. If you have opening closing, there's a chance you can convert into gross. So now for finding out cash flow from investing activity, what information you need at the end? There are so many information, but I need this purchase and I need this sale. Right? These are the two informations which I need. Right? So now I'll prepare. Is that fine? I think it's okay with everyone. Example 3. right? So now tell me, in the given case, it will be prepared in the gross method or net method? Tell me, in the given case, it will be prepared under gross method or net method? Many will say that, sir, gross method, because accumulated depreciation is given. Listen to me, my dear friends. It is not accumulated depreciation of assets sold. It is accumulated depreciation's opening and closing balance is required. Accumulated depreciation of assets sold is just an information that will come in that particular account. But in order to prepare that account, you need opening and closing balance of accumulated depreciation, which is not there in the given problem. So therefore, it will be prepared under net method. And net method, we have only one account, that is fixed asset account. There is no way out that you can convert these net figures into gross. Right? So in the given solution, you will be able to prepare only one single fixed asset account. Wherein two balance BD and closing balance 2 lakh and 4 lakh. Is that fine? Now, since the asset is maintained under which method? Net method. WDV 10,000, costing 30,000, accumulated depreciation 20,000. So WDV is 10. Now I am concerned with WDV. I am not concerned about its cost and accumulated. I am concerned about the net value of assets sold. So net value of assets sold is 10 and I have sold it for 15. Right? So by bank, I have sold it for 15, so 2PL, I will have profit on sale 5,000. Right? Now, depreciation provided is 60. So I have all the informations. I have sale, I have depreciation. See, under net method, in one particular account, all informations will come as to purchase, depreciation and sale. So depreciation they have given, sale they have given. What they have not given, which is the purchase. So purchase will be balancing figure, as simple as that. They will give you any two information, the third will be the balancing figure. So two bank account, purchase, balancing figure. So it is 2,70,000. So this information I need and this particular sale information I need. Right? So now I'll prepare cash flow from investing activity. So you have purchase of fixed asset 2,70,000 negative. And then you have सेल ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट 15,000 पॉजिटिव, इज दैट फाइन? आई गेस इट्स एब्सोल्युटली ओके. So in one particular account, all informations will come. This is fixed asset, this is depreciation, this is asset disposal, everything is fixed asset account, right? Next example, very important. Fixed asset one asset whose WDV is rupees 30,000 sold for rupees 19,000, depreciation provided during the year 10% per annum, prepare cash flow from investing activity. Is that fine? So I guess it's absolutely, the data are very clear to you. First of all, accumulated depreciations, opening and closing balance is not provided. So again, asset will be prepared under net method. Is that fine? Now, in this case, asset is maintained under net method. So, I am concerned about WDV, and WDV is directly given. So, 30,000 WDV is sold for 19. So, I will write by bank account 19. By PL, loss on sale 11. Now, the rate of depreciation is provided, not the depreciation figure. If we would have got the depreciation amount, I can easily get purchase as balancing figure. Or if I get purchase as balancing figure, I can easily get the depreciation. If I get purchase, I can easily get depreciation as balancing figure. So you can see that two information is missing here. Unlike last problem, they had given us depreciation, so we got purchase balancing figure, right? This one is the balancing figure, right? Kindly pay attention, very important problem for examination. Is that fine? But in the given problem, they have given us the rate of depreciation. This is very important. So tell me, if you see your depreciation accounting, which you have done in your foundation level, you must have remembered one thing, that either depreciation is to be provided on opening balance or on closing balance or on average, means during the year. So in the given case, what are we going to assume? If I assume that purchase and sale is done at the end, it means whatever I have purchased on that, no depreciation, and whatever I have sold on that, full depreciation. It clearly means that depreciation should be provided on opening balance, that is 5 lakh into 10%, that is 50,000. Right? If I assume that purchase at the end, it means no depreciation for purchases, and sale end means full depreciation, and this sale is there in opening balance, it means depreciation will be provided on opening balance. As simple as that. But generally we don't purchase and sell at the end of the year. Right? So what we do? Another option. This is option one. Another option is you purchase beginning and sale also beginning. It means on purchase full depreciation and on sale no depreciation. So it clearly means that opening, from opening balance I will subtract sale, because on that no depreciation and I will add purchase. So opening plus purchase minus sale is what? Closing. So depreciation should be provided on closing balance yes or no depreciation should be provided on closing balance. Further, this closing balance is taken from balance sheet, it means 10% has already been provided. So I can say that closing balance from balance sheet divided by 100 minus depreciation rate into depreciation rate. So if purchase sale at the end, it means depreciation on opening balance flat 10%. If purchase sale at the beginning, it means depreciation on closing, and that closing is from the balance sheet, it means that balance is after depreciation. So how to get depreciation? 7 lakh 20 by 100 minus 10 into 10, so that comes to 80,000. So whenever, if nothing is mentioned, I'll assume option 2. If in the problem they don't mention anything, I will take option 2. That's very clear. So if nothing is mentioned, I'll assume that purchase and sale is done at the beginning of the year. Therefore, depreciation will be provided on closing balance, that is opening plus purchase minus sale. However, this closing balance is from the balance sheet, it means depreciation has already been provided. So after depreciation figure, it means this is 90%. So how much will be 10? That's it. Is that fine, everyone? Okay, so always I'll assume this only. So in that case, I got the depreciation. So by depreciation, note 1, 80,000. So I'll get to purchase account balancing figure. Right, so if two things are missing, it means you have to calculate one and then only you can get another. In cash flow, these two informations are relevant. I guess this is absolutely fine with all of you, right? So if they mention that purchase sale end, it means provide on opening, flat. If they mention purchase sale beginning, if they don't mention, assume purchase sale beginning. That's a realistic example. Assumption, right? So depreciation on closing. However, this closing balance is taken from balance sheet. So this is after depreciation. So this divided by 100 minus depreciation rate into depreciation rate. Is that fine? So that's it for today's session, right? Do stay home, stay safe, and stay educated. Goodbye.